Get ready to match the stars. Greg Morris, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Roz Kelly, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Buellafont as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Raver.
Thank you, Johnny O. Thank you for joining us. You're a beautiful looking bunch, and
that's
I greet you.
That's a lovely suit there.
Thank you very much. All right. Would you join me in applauding Cecilia Dobrin and Betty Dugan? Cecilia is a current champ. She's won $5,700, and she's being challenged by Betty Dugan, who had her first round question, and as she found out, they're a little more difficult than the second round question. And are you ready to carry on, ladies?
Yes.
Okay. Follow me, and we'll carry on. No. We'll get your first round question in 1 minute and 4 3/5 seconds. Watch it. Okay, let's carry on now, ladies. There's the other first round question. This one is Cecilia's, and it reads as follows.
I'm ready, Gene.
Thank you. Van Gogh said, remember the painter, Van Gogh. He's a Van Gogh, as we say correctly. My girlfriend is stranger than I am. After I sent her my ear, she kept it around the house and used it as a blank. Van Gogh said that. Yes.
I finished.
After I sent her my ear, she kept it around the house and used it as a blank. Good girl.
I love your suit. You look so adorable. Let me put my glasses on. I hate it.
No.
No, it's a gorgeous suit. Is
that's that one of the new ones. Yes. Thank you, my dear.
She was the ear.
She kept it around the house and used it as a... Good. All right. Joyce?
Yes.
That's it. Now, Cecilia, Van Gogh said, my girlfriend is stranger than I am. After I sent her my ear, she kept it around the house and used it as a blank.
Ashtray?
Ashtray is a good answer. A couple of good choices here, and she came up with one of the good ones, Greg.
She sure did. Can I have my dunce cap
now? You may have a good one, too.
I said pincushion.
Pincushion?
All right. She was right. Weird.
Yeah, that is a weird use for it, but that's possible.
Well, Van Gogh had this very large ear, and it was very shaggy, and it had a lot of stuff on it. I said she used it as a dust rag.
A dust rag. A hairy ear.
A hairy
ear. Some ears are that way.
A hairy ear.
Yes?
Why
what do you say,
is
Captain?
A young Dutch boy nauseous? Now, I chose...
Where's the young Dutch boy?
I chose...
Ashtray. There we go. And he drew a picture of an ashtray. Roz, wasn't that sweet of Charles to do that?
Yeah, Charles is really cute.
He is cute. All right, Roz, we're up to you. He kept it around the house and used it as a...
Well, assuming the man had large ears, dustpan.
Dustpan. That would be big, wouldn't it?
It's a large assumption.
That's right.
I am a great admirer of art, and although I do not have the original done by the little Dutch boy, I do have a copy of this marvelous picture.
Yes, of course. Ashtray. That's a copy. That's not the original.
The original.
Yeah, I see.
Well, you always keep this.
Yes, of course. It's beautiful. Well done.
I saw 9 of them.
Yes, right.
Then you destroy
the original. You have 2. That's very good.
Thank you.
All right. Now, you...
I don't like this question.
Well, this was an easy question. Wasn't it easy? Easy for you,
right? I
don't
mean easy. It's the idea of it.
Oh, well, he did it. We didn't do it.
I know. Oh, I couldn't think of anything I said as a blotter.
As a blotter? I'll say you couldn't think of anything. Holy mackerel. Okay, now round 2 coming up here. Betty Dugan. Again, you have a decision
to make.
Oh,
I'll take A again, please.
You want A?
Uh-huh.
You may have B if you'd like it.
No, I'll take A.
A is your decision.
Right.
Okay, there it is.
There it is.
The die is cast. You can't change your mind now, because it's in my hand. All right. Sir Lancelot's new bride said...
Ooh.
She said, our honeymoon was a real disappointment.
Aww.
Sir Lancelot blanked a lot. Our honeymoon was a real disappointment. Sir Lancelot blanked a lot.
Sir Lancelot.
Sir Lancelot. To whom was he married? I've forgotten her.
Guinevere.
Guinevere.
Yes.
Was he married? I thought Guinevere was married to Arthur.
Well, they were. They split up.
Oh, they split up. Yes. Arthur and Guinevere split up.
And he got the custody, I believe, of the armor.
I see. Betty Dugan. Sir Lancelot's new bride said, "Our honeymoon was a terrible disappointment. Sir Lancelot blanked a lot."
Well, I have two of them, and I know...
Well, now...
I know.
Oh. Don't hit me.
I'll put snored a lot.
He snored a lot?
Mm-hmm.
Just for the heck of it, what was your other choice?
Slept.
He slept a lot?
Mm-hmm.
All right. She says snored a lot.
Well, she should have gone with the first. I think they're the same, though, aren't they?
Snored and slept?
Yeah, because
well,
you
don't know.
You gotta snore when you sleep.
I will not...
He slept a lot.
He slept a lot. No, they're not the same. That's right. You found out, didn't you? What do you say?
I said, you know, I had lunch with Helen one day.
Yes?
And she told me all about your honeymoon. And that's where I got my answer.
You
slept.
Oh, yeah. She's only kidding, Helen. What do you say?
I had lunch with Jack Klugman. Slept a lot.
You and Jack are an item now, Charles, are you? Hello there, Roz.
Hi.
You ready for this?
Yeah.
Our honeymoon was a real disappointment. Sir Lancelot snored a lot.
No.
No.
No, I got 98 in history, and everyone knows that he jousted.
He jousted
every chance he got. Yeah. He would joust and joust.
All right. Now, Betty, you got to match the two remaining ones to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Let's see what happens here.
I wish you'd known with that first one.
Slipped it in. So that means Cecilia wins another game. We thank you for being with us.
It's been a lot of fun. Thank you very much.
A lot of gifts will be coming your way, Betty Dugan. A pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for being on Match Game 77. Goodbye. Let's spin her off and spin a message or two for you. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. For her first number on the piccolo, she will play. No. Listen, you've been here before. Let's get right to it now. Cecilia, we polled the studio audience not too long ago, and we said, write down your best response to this. Blank on it. Blank on it. Now, if you match the answer that they came up with most frequently, you'll remember you get $500. For matching the second most popular answer, $250. And for the third, $100. And whom do you call on for an assist here? You're allowed three.
Richard.
Sit on it.
Sit on it is one.
Charles?
Step on it!
Okay.
Brett? I've got two and I can't decide. I think I'll say think on it.
Think on it. Step on it.
Showstop.
Number three.
Sit on it. Those are the three, Cecilia. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own. Have you got any other ideas?
No.
All right, you have to make up your mind about one of those. What is your instinct? That's what you ought to do.
Try sit.
Sit on it. Okay, go with you. Let's find out if it's up there, and so we'll begin down at the bottom and reveal a $100 response. Bet on it. Okay, we haven't got sit on it yet, but it may come up here. Slide it, please. Step on it. All right, last chance for sit on it now. Are you there? Go. Yeah! Atta girl. Now, then you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000, and to collect the amount of money, you got to match one celebrity.
Richard.
Okay. Stand on the blue dot in the carpet there, Cecilia, and face Mecca, and here it is. Good luck to you, my dear. Worth $5,000. Goes like this. Blank fur. F-U-R. Blank fur. Tough one. Getting another idea. All right. Now, Cecilia, he finally made up his mind. He had a little difficulty. I guess this is kind of a tough one. If you match the answer he's already written on that card, you get the $5,000. Give us your response now. Blank fur.
Rabbit fur.
Rabbit fur. That the only thought that came to your mind?
It's the only thing.
Okay. I guess this was a tough one. There are a number of good answers
fake
here.
Fake fur and
fake fur is the first thing I thought of. What did you say?
Cat fur.
Cat fur. Cat fur. What would you have gone with? What? Fake fur. I guess most of them would have said fake fur. All right. Listen, you've picked up a little more money here. As a matter of fact, quite a bit more. You're up to $6,300, and you're going to meet Michael Gelman right now. Let's welcome him. Okay. You know this lady, don't you, Michael? We welcome Michael Gelman. That's a nifty-looking outfit you're wearing there.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's a yodel outfit?
Bavarian.
Bavarian. Are you a yodeler, Michael?
Oh, I'm a dancer.
A dancer?
Yes, I folk dance.
You folk dance? So you wear stuff like that when you folk dance?
No, I have another costume for
that. Oh.
This is just...
Oh, that's your streetwear.
Yes.
I see. Where are you from, Michael?
I'm traveling out here from Maryland. I've been camping and folk dancing along the way and just having a good time.
They go hand in hand, camping and folk dancing, don't they?
Well, it's the greatest way to see the country.
It is indeed. This is a wonderful country. What's one of the most impressive sights you've seen in America on your trip?
Flying through the Grand Canyon.
Wasn't that thrilling?
Yeah,
I've done that.
For just $25, they took it right through.
That's right.
It's really great.
You go right down to the bottom of the river.
Yeah.
That is really thrilling.
Fantastic.
Another $5, you can go in a plane.
Yes.
Well, yeah, that's true. We had a thunderstorm, too. It was great.
Yeah.
Glad we were in the plane.
Yeah. Now, say again the name of your hometown.
Laurel, Maryland.
Laurel, Maryland.
It's near D.C.
Near D.C., yeah. Anything else you want to tell us about you?
That's about it.
That's about it. Good luck to you, Michael. You may have A or B.
B for Bavaria.
B for Bavaria.
B for Martin Bormann.
Dumb Donald is so dumb.
How
you're getting better. When his wife told him to take out the garbage, he took it to blank. Dumb Donald so dumb his wife told him to take out the garbage, he took it to blank.
Got it.
All right.
Wait a second.
Wait
just a
second.
A minute.
Okay. So you're a Bavarian freak, eh?
Born in Munich.
You were born in Munich.
Right.
So were you.
Hey.
What a coincidence. Two people born in Munich. You know this show goes to Munich? Have you ever been over there?
Many times.
It's called Schnickschnack. The Germans have no way of saying blank, so they say here. And the Kleiner, the Freundlich, Koinich, and the Schnickschnack. That's what they mean. You ready, Michael? Here we go. Dumb Donald is so dumb, when his wife told him to take out the garbage, he took it to blank.
Dinner.
Dinner is a good answer. Okay. I said, take it to dinner. What do you say?
Nobody could be that dumb.
Well, he is dumb.
Except my brother-in-law.
Dinner it is. One for you, Michael.
It's true. He did. He took her to dinner and then dancing at a little roadhouse in Encino.
Ah!
And you know where it is.
Yes, of course I do. But we don't tell.
Nichka, which folk put nichine at Wurzbach, Mach, Wunjitschka.
Which
means
dinner and dancing at the Big Mac Supper Club.
I never knew he spoke Latvian. Hello, Ross Kelly.
Hi, Gene.
Wife told him to take out the garbage. He took it to?
Yeah, dinner.
Dinner it is. Well, how are you, Michael?
Yes, I lived in München for 11 months in Schwabing. Do you know Schwabing?
Oh, born in the Schwabing Krankenhaus.
Yes, it is the artist quarters. Is that
not right? Oh, yeah, it's University of Munich.
We have your relatives. You'll share half the money you win. I use the old German word, dinner!
Tell us your dinner, Joyce.
Well, it's a dinner in a restaurant. Dinner in a restaurant.
Told him to take out the garbage, you took it to dinner. Took it to a restaurant. Okay. Now let's stop right here for a second or two and do a little business with America, and then we'll carry on afterwards. All right. Now, Cecilia, are you ready for yours? This is
so.
Your first round question. Mm-hmm. Listen carefully. Here it is. At the restaurant, George said, I just figured out where they got this strange cut of meat. I just saw the chef, and his blank was missing.
Cute. Isn't that a cute question?
It's a cute question.
There are more questions about
that. Strange cut of meat. Just saw the chef, and his blank was missing.
Show's getting
bizarre. All right. Cecilia. At the restaurant, George said, I just figured out where they got this strange cut of meat. I just saw the chef and his blank was missing.
His foot?
His foot. I don't know. That's a first round question. I don't know why you're awing it. It could be almost any part of the anatomy. What do you say, Greg?
Well, to carve and get to foot, that's a contortion.
Well, it would be difficult, yes.
It's a little tough.
Right.
Know, unless you're in my neighborhood. I said thumb.
Thumb would be a good one.
A small cut.
Yes.
No, darling. His whole leg was called leg of chef.
Leg of chef. Getting close to the foot there. What do you say, Chuck?
Getting away from the foot for a minute. Rump.
Rump. That would be the most tender part.
It was lovely.
Nothing like a little rump roast, right, Roz?
Yeah.
You like?
Oh, you devil. The husband is unhappy, shaking the head. No, no, no. Anyhow, I said the hand.
The hand. All right.
Film, give him a big hand.
Give him a big hand. No, she wants a foot.
Of derriere.
All right, now the rump roast there. What do you say?
It couldn't be the hand, Roz. You don't bite the hand that feeds you.
Showstop.
So I said Fanny.
All right. Three rump roasts there. All right, now you're going to get a chance to catch up here as we go to round two. Since he's matched all the celebrities, it will be your choice to choose A or B.
B.
Okay, Cecilia, you must match everyone on this, and the best you can do is tie. When Peter the Plumber died, they wrote on his tombstone, quote, he went the way of all blank.
Black.
When Peter the Plumber died, they wrote on his tombstone, he went the way of all blank.
Do you know that we have a lot of tragic questions on this show?
Yes,
too.
We do.
It's a very sad show.
But one must learn to deal with these things.
Well, it's hard, you know. Week after week, dealing with tragic questions.
Wait, Mom.
Greg is talking to himself. I think we're getting to him. Now he's writing something, and I'll read it to Cecilia. Cecilia, when Peter the Plumber died, they wrote on his tombstone, quote, he went the way of all blank, end quote.
Crooks?
What? Went the way of all crooks.
I couldn't think of anything.
You couldn't think of anything, eh? Well, let's see what happens over here. Now, you must match everyone to stay in the game. What do you say, Greg?
I said plungers.
Went the way of all plungers. What did the rest of you have? Went the way of all flush. Okay, come on down, Michael. You're the winner. And went the way of all flush. Oh, there's a spot. Well, Cecilia, how much money have you got here?
$6,300.
And you say your husband wants to buy a new car.
Right.
Well, I guess you can buy a new car with $6,300, can't you?
I hope so.
All right. Congratulations
Thank
to you.
Thank you. I really had fun. Thank
Good
you.
For you, Cecilia Dobrin. All right. Thank you for being with us at Match Game 77. Don't move, my dear. We'll move you. Okay, there she goes. Now, while we're spinning her off, we're going to spin a little message for America. Don't go away here, all right? You are all just Jim Dandy.
Oh,
brilliant.
And I look forward to seeing your beautiful faces and bodies on this very stage tomorrow.
Okay.
Listen, what are you doing these days with your life?
Well, I just finished doing a play in Detroit. That's over.
Oh, that's so you got nothing to say. Eight people from Detroit saw you, and they appreciated your performance.
We
appreciate yours.
Yes.
Join us tomorrow for Match Game 77. I'm Gene Rayburn. Tally Hall.